Good morning and welcome to a session on financial management. I am Vishal Mehta and I'll be taking you through this course of financial management. First and foremost, we need to understand what is money and why is it so important. Money is the common thread running through all the decisions taken by various managers, and there is hardly any manager working in any organization to whom money does not matter. If money is so important, what exactly does financial management do? Well, financial management is that managerial activity which is concerned with the planning and controlling of a firm's money, which is also the financial resources of the company. That brings us to the next question: what is financial management in that case? It concerns the acquisition, financing, and distribution with some overall goal in mind. This is where we need to understand what are we talking about. We are talking about acquisition of funds, we are talking about financing, we are talking about distribution of the profits. If I repeat this, we are talking about from where we'll get the money, where will we invest this money, and how will we distribute this money. And when we talk of some overall goal in mind, we need to understand what is the overall goal of the organization. First and foremost, we talk about the investment decision. Most important of the three decisions is the investment decision. Where will you invest the money? What is the optimal size of the firm? And on what basis would you decide how much funds do you require and where would you invest that money? What specific assets should be acquired and what assets should be reduced or eliminated from the firm? Next, we decide what is the financing decision, which will determine how these assets which we want to have will be financed. So what is the best type of financing? Should we get finance from owner's capital or should we borrow the capital? Should we issue equity shares or should we issue preference shares? Or should we issue debentures into the market? And if we want to go into all three types, what is the best financing mix? What should be the combination? Should it be a 50-50 ratio between equity and debt? Should it be a combination of equity, preference and debt? Or only debt? And is that a possibility? We'll explore these questions as we go by in the next sessions. As of now, let us understand which is the third decision. The third and more important decision is the dividend decision. What will you do to the profits that your company gets? Will you keep it in the business or you reinvest in the business so that future projects can be financed, or would you give it to the shareholders? That brings us to another term called shareholders. Who are shareholders? Shareholders are the owners of the company. They own the company. Each individual has a small share or small part of the company. So he becomes a part owner of the company. So all these shareholders are actually the owners. So what will they get? Why do they invest? They invest money because they expect dividends in return. So whether a dividend has to be declared or not, what will be the dividend payout ratio? These are some questions that will be answered by the financial management stream, and the manager who handles finance will take care of these answers. Now, we have decided, we have understood what are the three different functions of a financial manager, finance manager, and there is some overall goal which has to be kept in mind. So what is that goal? It is maximization of shareholders' wealth. Value creation occurs when we maximize the share price for the current shareholders. Does that mean that it is different from profit maximization? Yes, it is. Profit maximization and shareholder wealth maximization are two different approaches. Although to a common man it appears to be the same, but when we talk of shareholder maximization, wealth maximization I mean, then we are talking of taking a long-term perspective wherein we are taking care of risks involved and the time value of money. But when we talk of profit maximization, we may not really take into consideration all the risks involved. So what are the possible problems which we might face if we take profit maximization as a objective, as an objective. Well, you can increase your profits while harming the firm. That is, you might increase your profits by deferring certain maintenance work, or you might ignore the risk level of the firm, or you might not make certain payments, and whereby try and increase certain figures or manipulate certain figures. But when we talk in terms of shareholder maximization, we take a fair view, and we try that we take all the stakeholders into consideration, and that way we are able to maintain not only the shareholder's wealth, we are even able to maximize it. We will conclude this session today at this point, and we'll continue further at a later date. Thank you.